And here is the writer's almanac for Friday, February the 21st, 2020.
It's the birthday of the poet W.H. Auden, Whiston Hugh Auden, born in York, England, 1907, who in one of his poems described the moment when he decided to become a poet. He was a boy walking in a plowed field with a friend who turned to me, wrote Auden, and said, "Tell me, do you write poetry? I never had and said so, but I knew that very moment what I wished to do." It's the birthday of Anais Nin, born in Neuilly, France, 1903, studied psychoanalysis, was a patient of Carl Jung at one time, wrote in obscurity for most of her life until her diaries began to be published in 1966, diaries that were written over a period of 60 years. It was on this day in 1925 the first issue of The New Yorker came out, founded by Harold Ross and his wife Jane Grant, a reporter for The New York Times. Ross, the editor-in-chief, until he died in 1951. In the second issue, the editors published an apology for the first one. They said there didn't seem to be much indication of purpose, and we felt sort of naked in our apparent aimlessness. Circulation had dropped to 12,000 by the fall of 1925, but then it started to turn around after Ross hired E.B. White and James Thurber. Gradually, the magazine stopped dropping famous names and developed its own sensibility and style in short fiction and essays. The first cover featured a Victorian dandy in a top hat looking through his monocle at a pink butterfly, drawn by Ray Irvin, who also designed the distinctive typeface of The New Yorker. The man Eustace Tilley appears on the cover of every anniversary edition. It was in 1947, on this date, the inventor Edwin Land demonstrated the first instant camera, the Polaroid. The film, layered with little sacks of developing and fixing solutions, so after exposure, the film was squeezed between two rollers, which burst the sacks of chemicals, and 60 seconds later, there was your picture. It's the birthday of the novelist David Foster Wallace, born Ithaca, New York, 1962, author of Infinite Jest, which became a bestseller in 1996, even though it was more than 1,000 pages long with 100 pages of footnotes. Wallace battled devastating depression his whole life, committed suicide in 2008. His unfinished novel, The Pale King, published in 2011. He said, "Postmodern irony and cynicism has become an end in itself, a measure of hip sophistication and literary savvy. Few artists dare to try to talk about ways of working toward redeeming what's wrong because they'll look sentimental and naive to all the weary ironists. Irony has gone from liberating to enslaving. The postmodern founder's patricidal work was great, but patricide produces orphans, and no amount of revelry can make up for the fact that writers my age have been literary orphans throughout our formative years." Here's a poem by Charles Simic, The Week. "Monday comes around with a new tattoo it won't show us. And here's Tuesday, walking its latest nightmare on a leash. And Wednesday, blind as the rain tapping on a window pane. And Thursday, sipping bad coffee served by a pretty waitress. And Friday, lost in a confusion of sad and happy faces. And Saturday, flashing like a pinball machine in the morgue. And Sunday, with the head of crucified Christ hanging sideways in a bathroom mirror." The Week, a poem by Charles Simic, from his collection Scribbled in the Dark, published by Echo and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.